In 1950, Alan Turing predicted that within 50 years, computers would be able to fool humans into thinking they were a real person. He estimated that a human judge would mistake a machine for a real person about 30% of the time after a 5-minute conversation. This uncomfortably accurate prediction is now our everyday reality, given the rapid rise of LLMs such as ChatGPT and Gemini. But this wasn't his only prediction. In his work, he described in detail how AI will be created, trained, used, and he even estimated the hardware requirements to achieve this. And the most impressive thing? Turing wrote all of this back when computers were still rare, room-sized machines reserved for government and university use. Yet he already envisioned an entire roadmap for AI development, and he got it almost exactly right. Welcome to Codeolences, my name is Jakub, and today I'd like to show you Turing's incredible blueprint for AI, written almost 80 years ago. Alan Turing has a track record of turning impossible-sounding ideas into working systems. He was a key figure in the British codebreaker team responsible for cracking the German Enigma code. After the war, he greatly contributed to the field of theoretical computer science, pioneering concepts in algorithms, computation, and artificial intelligence, such as the Imitation Game, which we will also cover later in the video. But just 2 years before that famous 1950 paper, Turing wrote a lesser-known report titled Intelligent Machinery, in which he made some incredible predictions about the future of artificial intelligence. Imagine it's 1948. A small-scale computer still is the size of an entire room. As for memory capacity, it is measured in hundreds of bytes at best, not hundreds of billions as today. And yet, given these technological limitations, Turing introduced the concept of unorganized machines, a network of initially randomly connected simple units that can be organized by training. Think of it as a knot that learns how to untie itself. Turing speculated that such machines could be capable of general computation given sufficient network complexity and training. His intuition accurately predicted the rise of machine learning, as these unorganized machines are in fact very early examples of binary neural networks, whose more advanced versions are now at the foundation of every modern AI application. Modern neural networks start with layers of simple processing units, initialized with random weights, and are fine-tuned through a training process that takes in loads of data, extracts patterns from it, and updates the structure of the network using algorithms that apply the newly gained knowledge. End result is a model that can carry out complex tasks such as recognizing images or understanding language. But this is just the tip of the iceberg, as in the very same paper, Turing foretold an essential method for training artificial intelligence, namely reinforcement learning. But before we get into that, I need to keep those purple lights on, so let me quickly tell you about the sponsor of today's video, Boot.Dev. A big part of computer science is programming, and Boot.Dev is a platform built specifically to teach you how to code in a hands-on, game-like way. You gain XP, complete quests, and earn achievements while actually learning to program. And these aren't just some random tasks. You build real, tangible projects from start to finish. I personally started the memory management in C course, and it's been genuinely fun. It introduces the core concepts of the C language, and by the end, you build your own garbage collector. There are plenty of other courses too, covering Python, Java, TypeScript, as well as Linux and Git basics, which are essential tools every programmer should be familiar with. And best of all the content on Boot.Dev is free to read and watch, and the paid membership unlocks interactive features. They also offer a 30-day, non-questions-asked refund policy, and a free demo of the interactive experience on every course. Go to boot.dev and use my code Codeolences to get 25% off your first year of the annual plan, or scan the QR code on the screen right now. Thanks to Boot.Dev for sponsoring this video. Turing's vision for training the unorganized machines involved a pleasure-pain system, in which the machine would be rewarded for correct results and punished for errors. This is exactly the principle of reinforcement learning, a basic machine learning paradigm that involves training an AI agent based on its interactions with the environment. I think this is best explained with an example. You might have seen YouTube videos of people creating AI models to outperform humans in video games. Using reinforcement learning in a racing game like Trackmania, for example, could involve giving the AI agent information about the car's velocity, wheel direction or distance from obstacles, and rewarding it for achieving better times in a race, or punishing it for losing speed after crashing into a wall. After enough rewards and punishments, the model would learn how to optimally drive the racetrack. Again, this is essentially how Turing envisioned the training process of unorganized machines. As for the use cases of his invention, he wrote down this. The following fields appear to me to have advantages. Number 1. Various games, for example chess. The learning of languages. Translation of languages. Cryptography. Mathematics. Turing was spot on with this. Deep learning-based chess engines, such as the DeepMind AlphaZero, are now essentially unbeatable, constantly winning against world's best human chess champions. Similarly, neural network-based translation programs such as DeepL or Google NMT replace the phrase and rule-based translators due to their much better accuracy and context awareness. And that's the key idea running through Turing's work on intelligent machines. He constantly upholds the view that intelligence isn't programmed with rules in mind, but rather trained. This might seem obvious now, given that we are living through the AI revolution, but to make this observation 80 years ago was truly revolutionary. Although I find the methods and claims presented in intelligent machinery to be really impressive, these are still not Turing's most daring predictions. Those can be found in his most famous paper, Computing Machinery and Intelligence, that was published in 1950. In the article, Alan Turing tried to present his perspective on the question, can computers think? Instead of answering the question directly, he proposed playing the imitation game, now known as a Turing test, as a criterion for machine intelligence. In the standard interpretation of the imitation game, an interrogator is tasked with trying to determine which player, A or B, is human and which is a computer. The interrogator can ask questions over a text channel and is limited only to the written responses to make his decision. In the paper, Turing gives an example of how a potential conversation between the interrogator and one of the players could sound like. In the first line of your sonnet, which reads, "Shall I compare thee to a summer's day? Would not a spring day do as well or better?" It wouldn't scan. How about a winter's day? That would scan all right. Yes, but nobody wants to be compared to a winter's day. As you can clearly see, this is a conversation that one could definitely have with modern LLMs. In the paper, Turing also makes predictions about how machines capable of playing the imitation game could be trained. He again mentions the reward-punishment system, or reinforcement learning, which we already discussed. But he also mentions one more method that closely resembles what we now know as genetic algorithms. Turing envisioned the training of intelligent machines as starting with the capabilities of an infant child's brain and through the learning process, bringing it closer to the capabilities of an adult. He wrote, "We cannot expect to find a good child machine at the first attempt. One must experiment with teaching one such machine and see how well it learns. One can then try another and see if it's better or worse. There is an obvious connection between this process and evolution." He then went on to describe a procedure in which child machines mutate and improve generation after generation, leaving only the best machines in the selection process. What Turing described is the foundation of genetic algorithms that are inspired by the process of natural selection and are commonly used to find high-quality solutions to optimization problems. Just like Turing envisioned, through the evolution process, each following generation is better than the previous one until the most optimal solution is eventually found. But even this is not Turing's greatest prediction. In Computing Machinery and Intelligence, Turing states when he thinks a machine will be able to play the imitation game sufficiently well to fool a human judge. "I believe that in about 50 years' time, it will be possible to program computers with a storage capacity of about 10 to the power of 9 to make them play the imitation game so well that an average interrogator will not have more than 70% chance of making the right identification after 5 minutes of questioning." First attempts at testing this hypothesis were possible as early as in 1966, when Joseph Weizenbaum created the program called ELIZA, which would search the user's sentence for keywords before repeating them to the user in a slightly altered form, for example, as a question. Although the program was really simple for today's standards, it actually managed to fool some people into believing that they were talking to a human. But a real revolution in terms of the Turing test came with the rise of large language models. In November 2022, OpenAI released ChatGPT. Articles about GPT successfully passing a rigorous Turing test started popping up almost immediately, and it is generally considered the first computer program to do so. Recently, in March 2025, researchers from the University of California, San Diego, published a study which evaluated the performance of 4 different systems in the imitation game, just as Turing described it back in 1950. A judge held a 5-minute conversation with two different players, one human, one machine, and after that he had to decide which one they believed was a real person. And here's the crazy part. GPT 4.5, when given a specific persona to follow, was identified as the human 73% of the time, which is significantly more often than actual human participants. And this is how we went from Turing speculating about intelligent machines to people now mistaking those machines for real humans. And once again, thanks to Boot.Dev for sponsoring the video. Click the link in the description to learn more.